Wow. It's a beautiful sunny day. It is a beautiful sunny day. It's been a minute. My hair is orange and grown out. And then some of the sunlight is on. Been quite a few months. And oh, I don't know why I'm so nervous to do this right now. But I'm also so excited. This is such a, my life is changing drastically for the better in so many good and so many positive ways, and that makes me really, really happy. But we've been through it. We've been going through it. My life is so much different than where it was 8 months ago, or I think that was 8 months ago. I don't know. When I released my first video, now my life is so different and in the most positive way possible, and I'm so happy about that. I'm genuinely the happiest I've ever been. I love myself so deeply and so much, and I'm so grateful for everything that has happened from whenever I posted that video till now, because it's made me the woman that I am now. And it was challenging. It has been so challenging. I do this a lot with my hands. It's been so challenging and so tough, but here we are. I don't know. I have so much energy right now. It's been so challenging over the past how many months? It's almost been a full year to think about it. I think it would be 8 months because I released that first video in May. And it's now February. It's February 14th. Happy Valentine's Day. My favorite day of the year. This is literally my favorite holiday next to Thanksgiving. But I don't like Thanksgiving for what it stands for, what it is. I like Thanksgiving because I just like to eat. And there's no gifts involved. It's just a gathering. Basically, I just like dinner. Plain and simple. I love Valentine's Day. I know it's like a commercial holiday. You spend all this money. But it's all about pink and hearts and love, and I love it. I love love, and it makes me so happy. Let's just get into things. Where have I been? That's so funny. So I went to Portugal and Morocco with my friends this summer, and I recorded everything. I made vlogs and I edited them, and they were so perfect, I was gonna post them. And the person that I was dating at the time, he was not a good person, and that relationship ended. It was so toxic and so unhealthy, and I didn't realize it at the time, but once I got out of it, I reflected back and I realized everything that happened and how bad it was for me. So after getting out of that relationship and having everything edited and ready to post, I made the decision that wasn't going to do that because I don't want this person associated with me or my life ever again. And I'm so proud of how much work I've done on myself since all of that, and how hard I've worked to get out of that, and just everything I've built surrounding me, and the support system of people I have in my life, my family, my friends, like the people that truly lift me up and love and support me. I'm so grateful for all of them. I don't think I would be where I am right now if I didn't have all of them rooting for me in my corner, helping me and pushing me forward through everything I went through. It is still going on, but it's been challenging, but I'm so grateful for everyone in my life and my support system, my friends and my family. Like, you guys, it's because of you guys that I can do this right now, and I can feel good and I can feel better and I can push myself forward. I was just in a very toxic, unhealthy relationship, and I didn't realize until like December, you know, and I just didn't realize what I was in and what was going on. And so that person is no longer in my life. Oh, the second I say that, the sun just starts to shine. Like, if that's not a good omen, a good vibe, I don't know. That that person's no longer in my life, and I'm so happy about that. And I'm chasing my dreams, my goals, and I'm not gonna stop just because I faced some sort of difficulty and I went through things, and I've been going through things that could have gotten me down if I didn't handle them properly in myself. I made the vlogs for Portugal and Morocco. Beautiful. I would love to share that with you guys another time if I ever go back. I promise I will share it. I would recommend going there. It is so beautiful. I loved it so much, but it's not a time in my life to share anymore. And also, the person I was when I was making those videos was just not who I want to reflect. And who, does that even make sense? No, it was not. It was not who I want to put out there, and not who I want to be perceived as, because that's not me anymore. I don't really drink that much anymore. And on that trip, I'll drink occasionally. And if I go on a trip, I probably will drink again. But on that trip, I think, first of all, I was very depressed. I was very unhappy literally the whole time. If I didn't have my friends, I would have been so down bad. I love them. Victoria, Nicoletta, you guys, my riders, okay? I love you guys. But if I didn't have my friends during that time, help, save me. Save me. So during that time, I was really depressed. I was drinking every single day. Like, I'm talking every night. We're going out for a week straight. By the end of the week, I was like, I don't even want to drink. Like, I feel so drained. We just kept going. We kept going. And it wasn't until Morocco that we stopped drinking, because there isn't a lot of, we didn't go out that often, first of all, because where we were was not where the tourists stay. We were staying in like where the locals were, and it wasn't, we weren't doing it because we were like, oh, let's get the real experience. We picked an Airbnb. We said, this is very nice. It's close to the Medina. Perfect, let's go. And when we were getting in, we were all like, where are we? And it wasn't until I went to dinner one night and we were like, oh, wow. There's like, here's all the other tourists, you know, and this area is so beautiful. And not that the area we weren't staying in was beautiful, wasn't beautiful, but it was, there was no one that looked like us. Like, we stood out like sore thumbs, and it was a little frightening at times. Not frightening, I don't want to say frightening, but it was a little, it was a culture shock, and it was so uncomfortable at first. I've been to Sri Lanka with my grandparents because I'm half Sri Lankan, and I've experienced that before. I was with my grandparents, so I didn't feel as out of place, if that makes sense. But in this sense, we all were just very uncomfortable because we didn't have anyone, we didn't know anyone. It wasn't until my family friend came and took us out that we actually did stuff, because we didn't know how to navigate in that area without anyone. So it wasn't until that point. There really isn't, there's a lot of, the population is mainly Muslim, so there's not a lot of drinking. So that's where we kind of calmed down and we were breathing, which was good. We needed that. But back to what I was saying, I don't drink as much now. Don't drink as much now as I did, especially on that trip, because it's, my lifestyle has changed, okay? I love going to the gym. I'm wearing my gym clothes right now because I'm gonna go right after I film this. I love going to the gym. I'm really serious and focused on my health. A big focus in my life is my health and my mental well-being, my physical well-being. Those are things I really care for, and I love a slow life, a soft life. I'm not here for the hustle and grind. I'm gonna be honest. I will hustle in my dreams, and I will grind to make my dreams come true. It's not happening with the hustle and grind to make it to the top of a company. I respect and I love if that is your goal and that's what you want to do and that's where you're trying to go. I love it and respect it because I think that's a hard thing to do, and I think it's beautiful that you know what you're passionate about and you're going for it. It's not my passion, so I've never excelled in those areas. Going to university, no. I never did well in university. And I'm a smart girl. I'm very smart, but that wasn't an environment that I thrived in. Like, I always felt stupid. I always felt like I didn't know what was... I'm not stupid. But I always felt like I wasn't, like, meeting the expectations. I wasn't meeting with my peers, like, on the same level of intelligence. And I remember we'd get into, like, discussion groups to do things, or even, like, we'd have to get into groups in class to answer, like, a question. Sit there in silence, and I'd look at people because I didn't know what was going on. I didn't know what they were talking about. I also didn't have any friends in university, which, not that big of a deal. I would go from home to school and then go to my classes and go home. I knew it wasn't for me, but I was being told this is the path to success, and but anyways, back to what I was saying. My lifestyle completely has just changed. I love going to the gym. I love my health and my fitness. I love hot girl walks. I don't care what anyone says. It's so nice to just go outside for a walk at a slow pace. I'm not a cardio girl. I'm not the person you're gonna see at the gym running. Even outside, you're probably not gonna see me running. I want to try and run, but that's not my goal right now. My goal is just to take care of myself and enjoy the slow pace of life and enjoy, like, all the beautiful little moments that life has to offer that when you're going so fast, you don't see or realize. And it took the pandemic for me to enjoy that. And then once I got a taste of it, I'm like, I'm not letting this go. Are you crazy? Because of that, I want my channel to go in that direction. I still 1000% am gonna do my travel. 1000%. If I go on any trips, you guys are gonna be the first to see it, I promise. If I go on any trips, I'm definitely gonna vlog and capture every moment of it. I want my channel to be lifestyle and wellness and just happiness, and I just want to inspire anyone that feels like it's hard to live the life that you want, that you can, and just to enjoy every single moment of each and every day. I want to focus on positivity and travel and wellness and just love and happiness, because it's so important. We only have one life to live, and personally, I don't want to spend it not doing the things that make me happy. So I really want to share that and just inspire one person, even if it's like one person in this lifetime. I'd love to do more than that, but inspire as many people as I can to just do whatever makes them happy and just enjoy your life and not feel like you have to fit into this box that you're told is exactly what you're supposed to do, exactly who you're supposed to be, exactly what life is about. Like, this is your life and it's your choice what you want to do. And it took me so long to realize that. And I always wish I had, like, I'm an only child, but I always wish I had, like, an older sister to guide me through, you know? That's kind of my mom now. But I always wish I had someone to guide me and lead me. And I kind of just want to be that person for other people that may not have that, because I've done some embarrassing shit in my life. I was literally showing one of my friends the other day when I saw her a video that I posted on my Instagram story, and I was like, why did no one tell me to take it down? Because, like, obviously my friends are gonna support me and love me, but I was like, this was me in an era of my life that I was sad, I was lonely, I just wanted attention, male validation. We're gonna X that out. That's no more. But I just wanted attention, and I wish someone had told me. Obviously, I learned it through my own actions, but I wish that I could also help people to just live their life, learn through my mistakes, not have to go through some of the things that I've been through, and just be happy and just be positive and love and live your life. So because I was in a very toxic and unhealthy relationship, it broke me. It completely broke me down. And now I feel like I'm rising from the ashes. I feel like I'm growing into this beautiful, I have already grown into this beautiful woman that would never put up with those things again, that would never let myself be treated disrespectfully or hurt ever again. Like, I've grown so much in my self-love and my self-worth and my self-respect that no one could ever do that to me again. And it's such a beautiful, I don't know, it's such a painful to beautiful progress. I don't know how to explain it, but it was so painful and it became so beautiful because of who I am right now. And I'm so grateful. I actually am so grateful for who I am, and I'm so blessed to be here and to be able to be so strong despite what I've been through. I'll give you guys an update because I do plan on posting. I really hope to post once a week, but I'm gonna be honest, I don't even know what to make as a video next. I'm trying to brainstorm ideas, so if anyone has any ideas that you'd love to see, let me know. I'm so open to suggestions because I have no clue what to post and I have no trips coming up, so I don't know what to do, but I'm really happy that I'm doing this for myself and I'm going in a direction that makes me happy, makes me feel good, makes me feel positive. And I just feel like, I'm so grateful. I love life and I want to share that with you guys. And I do want to share some fun gym content with my friend because let me tell you, we are in the gym and we say the funniest shit ever to each other because we just love each other and we say the dumbest shit, but it's so fun and it's so funny and I just want to share that with you guys because I want people to just know who I am and get to know me. I want to be like friends, like literally. I know that sounds cliche and it might sound weird to people, but that's how I see this. Like, first of all of my followers right now are my friends. Literally all of my friends support me and my family, and I love you guys, and I'm grateful and I'm thankful for all of you who support me and love me and are, you know, here for me. You guys mean the world to me. But that's also how I just want this channel to be. I want it to feel like you're my friends, and because you literally are. I just want it to be me and my friends and my family, and we just spread love and spread positivity and joy and enjoy ourselves. Know when the next video will be out because I have to figure it out. I want to start posting on a weekly schedule, but like I said, I don't know what to post, so we're gonna figure it out. And I hope next week there'll be another video, but I'm just getting into it and figuring it out. But I would love to be posting once a week. I think that's my goal. I think that's my goal for this year, is to be consistent in posting and post once a week and just share love, positivity, happiness, joy, and be at peace. I am at peace, and I hope everybody gets to feel that in their lives because it is such a great feeling. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I know if you have watched this one, you've come a long way for my two videos, but thank you guys so much for watching this. It actually means so much to me that I'm doing it. Even if one person watches this, it's a big deal for me because I've gone through so much within the past year and I'm so proud of myself and I'm so happy that I've gotten to this point. So thank you guys, I love you guys, and I cannot wait to be consistent and post more videos. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe, follow me on Instagram, and yeah, thanks guys.